Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank Marianna Castiglione and the Dow Jano for inviting me to take part in this initiative. I am very pleased to have the opportunity to share some thoughts which have emerged from my study on the figurines representing musicians, dancers, and singers over my research activity. In this occasion, I will focus on figurines of musicians and dancers related to female world and childhood, some of which are grotesque terracottas representing caricatures of musical, dancing, and singing performers. Let me start by saying just some words about the function and the role of musical and dance performances in ritual context. As a virtual universal human activity, music and dance making is an essential social and cultural behavior, playing a fundamental role and providing an indispensable function in rituals and sacred manifestations in almost every ancient society. While music practice in the sacred sphere should be considered as an aspect of the actions that contribute to the effectiveness of the ritual, it is also necessary to consider it as more than a mere accompaniment or means of filling various phases of the ceremony with sound. Musical practice is an important aspect of rituals through which musical messages are transmitted to an audience within a precise context and sonic event. Indeed, musical performance must not only consider the instruments involved or what the musicians, dancers, or singers are accomplishing, but also the relationships between space, performance, and environment. Furthermore, the relationship with the audience and the behavior of audience itself must be taken into consideration in order to fully understand the role of music and dance in rituals and ceremonies which have religious and social implications. As an essential presence within the lived sonic experience of a cult and as a ritualized sound, music alongside other non-musical sounds evokes certain sensorial and behavioral responses in both the worshippers who perform and those who listen in a sacred space where complex soundscapes fully engage the ear of the worshippers. In antiquity, they could hear musical performances of all kinds, utterances, outbursts, and acclamations, the buzzing noises of crowns, and the sound of sacrifices, instruments, and worshippers. In this regard, a sacred space for musical and dancing performances can be considered a dancescape, by using a term of Frederick Nairbut, a ritual space used as a dance venue and mapped across the sacred place. As Catherine Bell has argued, performance communicates on multiple sensory levels, usually involving highly visually imagery, dramatic sounds, and other tactile, olfactory, and gustatory stimuli. Music and dance, two components that are inseparable in the sacred sphere, strengthen the power of performances. At a time when appropriate individuals acted during events, musical and choral performance in sacred cult could be considered a favorite means of communication with the gods and an offering to the deities completed in the framework of the ritual ceremony. Furthermore, music, sound, and voices, as well as natural sounds and sound objects, improved sensory experience and enhanced social interaction through the construction of a sacred environment and a sacred soundscape. From this perspective, terracotta figurines provide the strong visual evidence of various acts of worship and rituals involving music and dance performances. Regarding Greek ceremonies, ritual activity took place in a special location, the sanctuary, which was deemed closer to the other world and distant from this world. This setting produced a sensorial and behavioral response in worshippers and a feeling of connectedness. as images related to CART, terracotta figurines may have contributed to achieving the goal of ritual performances using music, dance, sacred verbal formulas, and the offerings of material gifts to the gods to induce a sense of the numinous in the participants. Thanks to their low cost, the terracotta figurines representing musicians and dancers made for perfect sacred offerings. Indeed, people who took part in musical and dance performances customarily dedicated personal objects to the divinities. In many cases, the figurines are the only visual documentation of musical and choral performances in cults and rituals. It is worth noting that terracotta figurines representing musicians, dancers, and singers are spread across a broad geographical space and a wide chronological spectrum in the ancient world. As some of the presentation at the paintings of the Archaeological Institute of America, sponsored by the Archaeological Archaeomusicology and Dance Interest Group, have highlighted, it is only recently that these figurines have been included into the body of sources and documentation for the study of ancient music and dance performances in connection with the context of their discovery, in order to understand their function in a sacred context as well as in domestic and funerary spheres. The results of these meetings on musical and dance archaeological evidence, which are published in the series and in the journal Telestes, have highlighted how figurines representing musicians, dancers, and singers serve as a valuable pieces of evidence, not only for reconstruction of their function in religious and social practices, but also for enriching our understanding of musical and dance activities in daily life of the past. Thus, through an anthropological and archaeology of performances approach to the study of archaeological evidence, which places musical and dance performances within an actual or symbolic space, the study of figurines representing musicians, dancers, and singers is an indispensable subject of investigation, which can shed light on ritual meanings and the social function of sonic events in antiquity, as well as on the role of music, sounds, and body movements in the life, in the cycle life. In this regard, terracotta figurines highlight the importance of music and sound in the female world and in the sphere of childhood. Examples of these figurines are the dolls playing crotala, well-known dolls playing crotala, and the nude female figures of young girls holding kimbala on their legs. Examples of these figurines, which seem to reproduce the image of young girls with slightly marked hips and breasts and a flat stomach, were found in the sanctuary of Fontana Calda. This is an example, Odian Butera, near Gela, where from the archaic age, there was an important cult of the nymphs and Artemis, and a connection with the female divinities and the water sources. Given the discovery of more than 100 female musical instrument players and dancers in this sanctuary, as well as the nuptial connotations of the other objects found there, these terracotta figurines seem to highlight how sounds and rhythmical movements were closely allied with ceremonies involving rites of passage and initiations, as well as nuptial rites and rituals of social transformation involving offerings of objects related to female childhood. In this context, the female figurines holding kimbala, which like timpana, were percussion instruments particularly suitable to accompany the dances and the ritualized movements of the young girls, not only had a ludical and educational function, but also a sacred and initiatory meaning. Thus, evoking the end of childhood games of girls ready for marriage, the offering of figurines holding a kimbala could also suggest a relationship with the koroi, the group of girls who, still maidens, danced accompanied by the rhythm of percussion instruments, exposing themselves to the admiration of young males. Moreover, as Britain's sources state, the custom of dedicating musical instruments and sound toys as a parquet during wedding ceremonies, sometimes with a doll, the net holding back the hair, and the ball, at times itself a rattle containing a little stone, symbolizes the passage to a new status in the adult world. An example is offered by the well-known epigram in the Palatine Anthology, where it is mentioned the prenuptial offering of Timarete to Artemis, the patroness deity of the female transition phases. The percussion instrument and the other objects dedicated by Timarete are associated with adolescence. Their dedication to Artemis signifies for the young girl the end of the period that they symbolize and probably at the same time the transition to adulthood through marriage. An interesting issue rises by these figurines concerns not only what music and playing music and dance meant for ancient societies, but also which musical instruments were best suited to the particulars of diverse ritual locations. The terracotta figurines representing musicians and dancers help us to understand the functions of particular instruments in different religious spheres and ceremonies. Generally, such instruments are depicted being played, but they also are often merely held in the hand, functioning as attributes or sacred objects with the ability to enter into relationships with gods. If wind, stringed, and percussion instruments have specific roles associated with certain religious spheres and ceremonies, then the depiction of these instruments on the terracottas may shed light on what types of music were performed on particular ritual occasions. Musicians playing wind instruments are depicted most often because these instruments accompanied the processions to sacred places. Indeed, the wind instruments were played during the sacrificial rituals and dances performed at ceremonies that required a large number of performers, not necessarily professionals. Percussion instruments marked the time, underlining rhythmic and metrical patterns of music, and produce an exciting noise for the rhythmic movements particularly connected with cults. For this reason, the depiction of drums or tambourines must be connected to the widespread function of music being closely related to dancing movements. Instead, as the figurines of female players of lyra, as in this example or in this example, which are represented single or in groups, for example, found in the cave sanctuary of Grotta Caruso in Locri, the main functions of figurines holding stringed instruments seem to involve music and dance performed during rituals and of socialization and integration. These instruments conveyed a strong symbolic meaning related to these rituals in which boys and girls were admitted into the society of adults. In this regard, one of the most interesting examples are the clay statuettes from the sanctuary of Karayeb, located in southern Lebanon, discovered during the Karayeb Archaeological Project mission directed by Ido Giano. As Mariana Castiglione has argued, in this sacred place, the number of Hellenistic figurines representing young girls and children or holding instruments is striking. Regarding the figurines, representing lively musical and dance activities, they could be recalling a sacred setting during seasonal feasts, often with the active participation of worshippers. An example is offered by the figurines of female and male musicians dating to the 4th to the 3rd century BCE from sanctuaries in Magna Graecia and especially in Sicily, where they are emblematic of a change in musical and dance performances, includes association with the drama on the island related to the range of gods, including Demeter, Dionysos, Aphrodite, and Apollo. These, as Becher highlighted, these figures, some of which were found in theatrical places, in connection with the shrines, show female musicians who are singing and dancing and playing wind, stringed and percussion instruments. Others are wearing masks or transparent clothes. These figurines may represent musical and dancing activities and sonic events performed by professionals and non-professionals in a cultic context. Their production could be related to the phenomenon of the so-called new music, especially in Southern Italy, in which the spectacularization of music was an essential aspect and very criticized. Some male figurines are depicted as grotesques or caricatures, some of which are squatted. The latter figurines seem to recall the noise performances of ritual reenactments that included the masked and costumed actors in a sacred setting, possibly related to Dionysos or to the seasonal festivals. It is worth noting that especially regarding grotesque figurines representing aulos players, as in the case of the slide, the instrument that embodied the true festival spirit accompanied the processional approach to the shrine. We can assume that this wind instrument, sound marking, served to bond the worshipping group closely together, shaping the sonic space as well as accompanying dances, deepening perceptual sympathies between members and heightening collective feelings of euphoria and enthusiasm. The caricatures of the musicians may refer to special instrument players who were rumored in popular belief to possess supernatural sexual power, as it is well evident in this image. In conclusion, figurines depicting musicians and dancers related to the female world and the childhood, some of which are grotesque terracotta representing caricatures of musical dancing and singing performers and female and male musicians, are not simply dedications and material objects, but are dynamic and expressive products of human musical and body movement behavior in worship. These depictions may have been conceived as a souvenir of a particular moment in a given ritual that involved not only priestesses and or cult personnel, but also singers, dancers, and musicians in the context of popular and seasonal festivals. Thus, it is necessary to consider the representations of musical instruments and figurines representing musicians and their relationship with the religious sphere on a case-by-case basis, while keeping in mind the polysemic nature of terracottas representing musicians, the different uses of the same representations for different sacred occasions, and when possible, the differing archaeological context within which the figurines were found. The link between sacred events and musical performances during their celebrations, especially related to seasonal festivals and ceremonies of initiation, could be the key for understanding the symbolic meanings and the rich production of depictions of male and female musicians and dancers in ancient Greek choroplastic art. Thank you so much for your attention.